Hey everyone! This is Hirotanamai 2011. Welcome back to more Let's Play Crash Twinsanity. In the last episode, we obtained Nina Cortex, I'm treating her like an item. That's very chivalrous. The final party member of Crash Twinsanity, or at least basically the final party member, considering a lot of the other stuff that was supposed to be in the game is cut, but that's neither here nor there. In this episode, let's see if she can fix the Psychotron, because that was kind of the whole point of all that padding to go and collect her, not just introduce her. So, as soon as we go in here, cutscene will activate, and let's hope that she can fix it for us, shall we?
Come now, as we explore a new dimension!
It should have been two new dimensions, but we ran out of time.
Your fur is so soft and warm. Evil Crash! No! Come along!
So again, a few things about what just happened. Yeah, we made it. We're in the 10th dimension with the really, really foreboding music that I really, really like. Especially for an acapella, this song is like really amazing. Oh, a few things about that cutscene. I love how all Nina had to do was just hit it. But then again, she does have bionic arms, and maybe we just weren't strong enough to fix it on our own with that. Two, I love Cortex's, "Your fur is so soft and warm." And three, the evil Crash, he's not related to fake Crash, the really bad Japanese plushie that was made for Crash Bandicoot a long time ago that eventually became his own character because of how unpopular it was. But he's a new character for this game because the 10th dimension, you guessed it. It's kind of cliche, but the 10th dimension is essentially, is this going to stop me over? Yep. The 10th dimension is essentially the cliched, dark side dimension where everything is evil. And, well, evil and opposite, basically. As you can see, instead of an iceberg lair, we are in a volcano lair. And fun fact, there is no collision down there, because if you try to jump down here, like I'm going to show right now, you die because it's too high up. But, essentially, there's no collision data if you're able to make it down there, but this was supposed to be a level at one point, and, well, you guessed it, it got cut. Also, something weird is that, pay attention to the fact that the ocean is blue. I'm gonna bring that up a bit later. Also, I love how Nina and Crash, when Evil Crash showed up, they're just both like, whoa. Anyway, I'm trying to sound enthusiastic here, but remember how I said that, the first snowboarding level was basically my favorite level in terms of how funny it is, but honestly, it sucks in terms of how it is as a level? Yeah, well, remember how I also said that this is basically, the second type of a snowboarding level is the worst one in the game. Yeah, guess what it's time for. We're finally going to be tackling that really, really bad snowboarding level. As soon as we go through here, as we can see Evil Crash kind of just standing there with Nina. Well, let's go after him.
My daughter, niece! We must do something! Think, Cortex, think!
Welcome to, as soon as I can pause the game, that was weird, I couldn't pause the game for a minute. Welcome to Rock Slide Rumble, the worst level in the game. Now, the way that the level's presented, they want you to chase after Evil Crash and Nina. Don't... I already have to start over. Oh god. Oh, this is not going to be fun. This is not going to be fun at all. Is there a checkpoint down there? Because I just want to kill myself so I can start over. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, you can also see a gem over on that side. In any case, the level presents itself as you have to chase after... Where is he? Okay, that's weird. He didn't load. You have to chase after Evil Crash and rescue Nina. Don't worry about that. Basically, Evil Crash serves as nothing but just an obstacle, because you'll literally, I kid you not, you'll get hurt if you touch Evil Crash. And it's very weird like that. And essentially, you know, this is basically just a hard version of, this is just a hard version of the other level. But, oh god, this level, yeah, it is bad. As you can see, I'm already struggling. If anything, I can give this level a bit more credit. Unlike the last one, where there's a lot of checkpoints in really dickish areas, so essentially you have to perform... the computer froze for a second. As opposed to the last level, there's basically a bunch of dickishly placed checkpoints where you essentially have to perform a no-hit run if you're going to collect all the gems, this one is a bit more forgiving, in the sense that if you miss any gems, there are plenty of places to kill yourself before getting a checkpoint, so you can just go back and collect them. And also, you don't have... Because you, keep gems when you die, so long as you don't get a game over, it's a lot easier to get gems here. However, I say that is a lot easier. Okay, I'm going about this the wrong way. I'm sorry. I keep dying in the same place. It's a lot easier to get gems in this area, except for one, and you will see why. I guess I can point it out now, since I'm trying to get this gem over here. Also, yeah, touching any enemies here will hurt you, because you're not invincible while you're doing this. Okay, I'm sorry, I just got a text. My phone, I should have turned my phone off. I apologize about that. Cortex is... Well, there's one gem that we have to get in this level, and, it's in a really uncomfortable spot where, remember those holes in the wall that I got through in the other, snowboarding level? Well, yeah, this time around, you are actually expected to... Okay, I am really doing this the wrong way. You know, I might actually get a game over again on this stage, and I don't know... I actually forget how to get the gem here. I probably should have looked up how to do this level before coming into this, because I kind of just popped in the game to record this, because today's Friday, so I'm recording this the day before you guys are going to see it, and yeah, I kind of, like, you know, I don't do stuff like practice... Okay! Well, I died, but I got it, and my computer froze, like, so many times when I was getting that. I guess I couldn't handle the stuff on screen. And, you know, it sucks too, because I'm down to one life, so most likely I'm probably going to have to do all this over again. But anyway, I kind of don't believe in practice files and whatever, just because, you know, realistically I should, but I feel it's better if, like, you play this game with the intent of knowing what you're doing, but, like, you know, messing up and experiencing new things. Okay, there's Evil Crash. Again, like I said, don't touch Evil Crash, because you will actually get hurt. So... The game the way the story is going is that you're supposed to chase him, but really all you're supposed to do is just follow him, because he's just serving as another obstacle, and oh, I'm invincible. Okay, this area right here. You see how I got this yellow gem here? And, you know, that wasn't really all that bad. Oh, I thought I could make it. You saw how I got the yellow gem there, and it wasn't really all that bad? Well, here's the thing. There's a second one of these that is basically covered by a wall of TNT crates. And you have to be frame perfect in order to get it. Actually, I think this is it right here. What? Okay. I have to say something right now. My first real time 100%ing this game was about a year ago when I was playing this for friends over Skype. And I was screaming when I finally got this gem, because I have purposely avoided getting this gem, because this is one of the hardest gems to get in the game, so I just said screw it. I can't believe I just got that on my first try. I thought this level was going to be hard. I just got the hardest gem on my first try! Okay then, I guess the gods are looking over me. I probably shouldn't have spoke up. Okay, that's my fault. Yeah. Well, now we get to see that game over screen. Yeah, well, here's the thing. I got that on my first try, but there are gems to follow right after. And the whole problem of the momentum gets messed up unless you're pressing a direction. I'll meet you guys back at the checkpoint. Okay, to be fair, that was all my fault.
A few moments later.
How did that kill me?
2,000 years later.
Double whammy.
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting, and they had to hire a new one.
Okay, I'm back, and I got the gem, and, I got the gem, and now I'm dead. Alright, you want to grind on this part right here, or not? I think there's nothing on this, but I'm gonna get it anyway. No! The last one was right there, and I just so happened to get it! Okay, that's what I was thinking of in the other level. That's what sucks. That's the one that you have to get all of them perfectly. And you want to know the best part about all this? I was complaining that, okay, these gems take forever. I got those on my first try, but the one at the beginning is the one that kept killing me. Man, talk about Let's Play Curse. Like, this game is, like, so, like, full of that right now. Like, I am not even fronting, but overall, this is actually a pretty good run of the level, so I'm not really going to complain that much. This level went by not that bad. I actually kind of surprised. Okay, so, not much to... That is so cheap! Okay, thank God that wasn't a game over, because I was going to be so angry if it was. Why would you place nitro cards right underneath me? Yeah, okay, that's why! Because you're supposed to let... You're supposed to let Evil Crash go in front of you so he can get rid of the nitro cards. He wasn't there. He despawned. Oh, God. Bad game design at its finest. Okay, whoa. My computer keeps freezing. Stop that. Well, Evil Crash spawns out and, well...
This way!
Cortex, since when do you have that ability? I want that ability. That ability's cool. Why don't I have that ability? I'm gonna get rid of these things, because these things suck. And by the way, they're gonna send you back to the beginning! With a bad camera angle! What is this? Okay. I was worried for a second, because it's like, whoa. Alright, here's the thing. Remember how I said that at Dingle Dial? Because of both the placement of the rats, and the fact that the game, you know, frankly, doesn't... No! No, 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 no. Oh, okay. Whew. All right. I'm sorry for swearing there, but okay. All right. At least I got a life. Here's the thing. Remember when I said at Dingle Dial, both the game crashing and the rat placements can cause you to die? Yeah, same thing here. There's no checkpoint here. So if you get a game over, you gotta do it all over again. And also, if you, fall from this height, it counts as a death. So be careful, because these guys suck down here too. I was so worried that I was gonna get a game over and have to start all the way over. Okay, well, we got an autosave checkpoint, and here we are. We are in the main area of the 10th dimension, Twinsanity Island, with a Chaos Emerald and the waterfall, the evil twins in the background, and a very foreboding dark aura. I love the atmosphere of this place. Like, if I haven't said it before, I love the way that Crash Twinsanity looks. Like, it's one of my favorite-looking Crash games in terms of design, just because, like, how, like, cool everything is. Also, I love the song. It's a dark remix of Insanity Island's theme, and it just works so good, especially if you hear the two of them mixed. It's, like, such a, like, melodramatic piece. It's actually pretty cool. Okay, so here's the thing. Originally, I was going to make this its own episode, but we went through that pretty quickly, so I'm going to include Twinsanity Island in this episode as well. So here's the thing about Twinsanity Island. It has its own set of Chaos Emeralds, just like Insanity Island, but it's split into two, because, again, because of time restraints, Twinsanity Island is actually relatively short, and you'll be surprised at how short Twinsanity Island is. Okay, my computer froze again when I was when I landed on that platform, so it's like, oh, come on, did the game kill me? But, yeah, so it's split into two parts. So not all the Chaos Emeralds are here, but most of them are. But this section of the hub world is actually pretty big. So I may have to jump around and stuff because some of these puzzles can get pretty annoying. Case in point. Anyway, like I said, some of these puzzles are actually pretty tedious. So I might have to cut around because, yeah, this area is pretty big. And again, if you die, you got to do the puzzle all over again. So, yeah, I apologize if there's any cutting, especially because I'm about to get another game over because of how low my my life score is. So, yeah, I guess if anything, I'm going to start being quiet now, and I'm going to play a montage with the Twinsanity. I'm going to play a montage of me getting the Chaos Emeralds around Twinsanity Island Beach while you guys get to listen to the Twinsanity Island theme. So I'll see you guys after I collect all the Chaos Emeralds. I'm sorry, I was kind of distracted. You may have heard that boom in the background. Yeah, I don't exactly know what causes it, but my only explanation is that in the background, one of these bomb things are loading, and they explode because no one's touching it. Because essentially the entire area is loaded, because you can even see where we have to go in the distance, which is really cool. But yeah, I digress. I'll see you guys after the montage.
Let's get moving!
Okay, after all that's said and done, I'm back. One thing I want to point out before we continue the story. Yeah, you see that hole over there? This is the counterpart of the shortcut in Insanity Island that would take you back to the beginning so you can start the story over. But as far as I know, unless you glitch it, there's no way to get in there. And I believe that's left over from when the volcano lair was supposed to be a level. Also, yeah, while I was doing that montage, I figured out after years you don't have to do that puzzle and waste time. You can just clip through the force field with your belly flop attack. Well, it saved a lot of time and effort on my end. Anyway, to get all the gems, you had to see the Cortex cutscene once. So, to keep the illusion, I'm gonna jump cut. See you guys there. Fresh shiny new one up. All right, let's go and rescue Nina, shall we?
There they are.
Let her go! Take me instead!
Okay!
Cortex really can't stop getting into trouble, can he? Also, I love the, expression on, Evil Crash's face when Cortex said, "Take me instead!" He's like, "Okay." Also, by the way, don't touch Nina! Oh. Okay, I was getting my information wrong. Apparently, Nina is actually a block in the game's data. She's not an enemy. Never mind. Also, I love how she's just blinking her eyes, just like, I can't believe he left me here. And I can't believe Crash is going to leave her here also. Evil Crash's house, by the way. I love how it literally is just a demented version of Crash's house, and we don't get hurt by the spikes. Okay, whatever. We're going to just continue on. I guess we have to save Cortex because Nina is capable of getting herself out of that situation, even though realistically we were there to save her, so why did we just leave her behind? Oh, well, I guess I'm not here to question stuff. I'm just here to play the damn game. But we have reached the next level of Twinsanity Island. As soon as I can pause the game. Bandicoot Pursuit. You're already guessing what this is going to be about. But I think we reached a good stopping point. So in the next episode, let's go rescue Cortex and... Ooh, I never noticed that black hole. I guess the evil twins weren't joking when they said they were ripping a hole in the universe. Well, see you guys next time.